Gerald Kevin. He's a Beaumont native, a Lamar University graduate, and he has started several businesses here. So if y'all help me welcome him.
Thank you. Thank you. It's great seeing all of you come in one at a time, because at first there was only just a couple of us in the room, and I thought, wow, this is going to be the biggest flop at Lamar today. But I'm glad you're all here. I'm glad you made it. I'm glad you're recovering from your injuries, because when you're doing this, I know you're not just doing the OU. There's something else going on. So congratulations to you. Well, look, the year has already started. Gosh, we're on January the 25th. 2016, just a few months ago, you enrolled in college. Just a few months ago. Time is really moving fast. So now what we want you to do is start considering what you need to do to build your strengths so that you can become stronger, so that you can be more competitive in this world, so that you can find your flaws. Oh yeah, we all have them. Everybody's got a few flaws. I carry a bag full of them with me. Sometimes I look in them to see what I'm still missing, and sometimes I look in them to give me inspiration to go further. We've all got flaws, and today we want to talk about ways for you to get your strengths, to gather your strengths, to find your strengths. Because a lot of times your strengths are not as hidden as it seems. Many of you are suppressing them because you don't realize you have them. You don't want to recognize them. Some of you are shy, very shy, not sure. I'm just kind of going along. I think I'm going to figure this out as I go. Hey, I'm just a student. What the heck? I don't have to yet. I still got time. My daughter this morning, who's 14, told me, "Dad, I don't have to get up early. I'm just going to school. I just need to get up in time to get dressed and get down the stairs." And I said, "Yeah, you're right. That's all you gotta do. That's all you gotta do. But will that take you where you need to be?" And of course, driving around, going through traffic, hitting a few lights, guess what? We're 5 minutes late. Okay, 5 minutes late. You ever heard the old adage? I believe it goes something like this. On time is early. Early is on time. On time is, I believe it's something like acceptable. And, I messed that up. I'm sure it's in there somewhere. There's three different stages. If you're early, you're on time. If you're on time, you're late. And if you're late, you're unacceptable. Thank you. And so the scenario is that's how it goes in life as well. Being on time is expected. Being available to find your strength is expected. You see, if we all went along without trying to find our strengths, we would turn around and decide, gee, I think enough is good enough. Whatever that may be, it's just good enough. And I want all of you to understand today, we're going to explore some ways for you to find your strengths. And the first way is, are you awake? Are you awake? Have you found your inner self awake? Because just as getting up late and just as getting prepared for the day, if you're not awake, if you don't feel like you're alert to go into your classes, to go into your daily challenges, whether it's sports or business or academics, if you're not alert enough at that moment that you're called upon, you'll miss your opportunity. So the very first thing I want all of you to look at is, are you alert? Are you alert at the time of need? Sure, we can all lounge out and become couch potatoes, relax on the sofa, watch the football, check out soccer, look at the latest cooking shows, figure out how to do your great auto repairs or home improvements. Those are great leisure times. But when it's really critical for you personally to do something, you have to be really alert and awake. Coaches say, get your head in the game. Other folks say, Are you ready? There's any number of slogans that people pull together to try to say, are you ready? Are you alert? Because not being alert is the first way of making a mistake. You certainly wouldn't want your doctor, who's going to do surgery on you, to have had one of those mornings when he's not alert. and he's about to operate on you. And therefore, he's all of a sudden struggling to do his task. Well, no different for you. You have to be able to come in, take a look at yourself, and get yourself ready for the morning. Now, there's all kinds of rituals, alarm clocks, coffee, wash your face, whatever it is. Getting yourself ready for that day and being able to tackle it is most important. Because listen, as you go through this process of finding your strengths, the first thing you have to be, you have to have the on switch on. There's no equipment or electronics that work with the button off. It's all got to turn on. And the idea sometimes that, hey, that's enough, that's good enough, I've got it, you probably won't reach your max potential. And all of you will be successful one day. Now, that's probably odd for me to say it. I've never met any of you. But all of you will be successful one day. Some of you are going to reach your potential much faster than others. Some will be through academics. Some will be through the opportunity of luck. Some will be through the opportunity of persistency. But any number of methods, all of you, I predict, will be successful one day. It's all about the path. And possibly something I say today, one statement, one word, one thought, may make you figure out how to get to your successfulness faster. That's my intent. And it's also the intent of your parents and significant folks who have helped raise you in your family or network of friends and family. You see, those same folks are thinking, are you awake? Are you ready to get started? Are you going to be successful? Because nothing will bring joy more to them than for each of you individually to be successful, for you to be able to reach the goals that you're going to preset for yourself. No matter what they are, it can be world peace, it can be learning how to grow clover. It really doesn't matter. It's all on your own personal level. You see, once you leave Lamar, it's all about you. And you go, well, that's a slogan about being selfish. Nope. That's a slogan about you being your own self-starter, you getting yourself up, you getting prepared for the day, you understanding what the goals are, you getting yourself dressed, ready, and hit the go button. It's all about you. Because the rest of this world doesn't really care. The rest of this world's going to go through their own little trials and tribulations. Sure, they'll help you, but this is a lot like bumper cars. You're going to start getting nudged and bumped by others. You see somebody going too slow on traffic, what's the first thing you think? Get out of my way. I got places to go. I got people to see. I know what I'm doing. Why don't they? The same scenario is when you're looking for your strengths. Look for your strengths. Get in line. Get ready. Get yourself prepared. Get your mind ready. Get your body ready. Are you sleeping enough? Who in here had enough sleep last night? Raise your hand. I want to see the first person. Oh, look here. We got a few. Got a majority that went, not so. Okay? Sleep. Sleep deprivation. It goes into a whole new bucket of problems with sleep deprivation. One of the best things you can do to get yourself ready, to find your inner strength, is treat yourself right. Treat your body right. Now, I'm not a doctor. I'm not going to go into things that would require you to be medically examined. But I'm going to give you the basics. Sound sleep. Eating correctly. Being able to be alert when you are awake. Giving yourself enough exercise. Getting yourself in the right environment to be happy. Okay, a lot of folks jog and exercise as a stress relief. Of course, it releases endorphins, and then all of a sudden they feel better. But it's also a great way to get rid of that ugly test you just took 15 minutes ago. If you go jog, you go walk, you go enjoy the trees, the scenery, the flowers, the oak trees around here, the campus life, man, how great will it be to just take that stress down and come back to a nicer place, an internal place. Man, that's nice. That's when you know you're a little more awake with the world. That's when it's important.
Well, as you start measuring yourself and start trying to find your strengths, you're going to obviously turn over a few things that's going to be your weaknesses. You're going to see some things that you're not particularly proud of. Here I am, big procrastinator. I love to procrastinate. I know it's due Thursday. I may not hit it till Wednesday night. That's one of my weaknesses. But I kind of like working under pressure. There's a certain part of me that just gets jazzed up on the idea that when the ideas hit, I'm flying. I'm going all the way through it. There's also a handicap to that. You can trip and fall. You can skid a lot of skin off your knees by tripping and falling on sharp deadlines. So what I try to do now is trick myself. I move up the dates. I move up the dates when it's not required. I go, you know what? It's due on Friday, but it's really due on Tuesday. Okay, let's get started. It's Monday. And then we get going, and we get going. And I don't have to polish it off 100%, but I need to get about 85% of it knocked out. So that if I go, oh man, let's take a break. I need some pizza. Well, if you turn around and slow down at that point, and you've got 85% done 4 days ahead, you can walk back up to it, and it's like a walk in the park to make it on Friday. You can do Thursday night real easy, and then bang, turn it in on Friday, boom, you've got it. You have to trick yourself into understanding that your weaknesses are a part of you as much as your strengths. And so what you have to understand to be able to do is recognize them and then move in to correct them, self-correcting, okay? So now, we'll get into a few other little things here about, are you prepared? So you're getting ready to do your projects. You're thinking about what you're going to do in the future. And let's just say you're coming to see me. I'm an employer in this area. I have four different companies with four different skill sets of people working for me. It's really a neat thing. And so what I do a majority of time is review interviews and application forms and then bring folks in if I meet. And so as they get to working with me, we all have to set a mindset that you're prepared for your interview, that you're prepared to work in the position that I have for you at one of my companies. The whole idea is that, are you prepared mentally? Are you prepared emotionally? Are you prepared physically? Some of the jobs are physical. Some of the jobs are more mental. Some of the jobs are emotional. You go, now what kind of jobs have you got that are emotional? Try being a receptionist at the front counter of a location. You can get beat up in less than an hour. If you're weak, you're out. If your emotions are on your shoulder, you're a dead man. You've got to be great to be a receptionist. You've got to smile through the telephone. You've got to see, let them see your pearly white teeth through the phone. Because you know what? They're looking for a reason not to like you. They're looking for a reason that I knew it was going to be like this today. Heck, it's Monday. Besides that, this weekend it was a full moon. I knew it. You have to work harder as a receptionist. You are projecting my image. You have to look nice, speak nice, be considerate, offer things for others as a gift, a bottle of water, a place to sit, something to snack on, whatever it may be. But you have to work harder as a receptionist. A lot of people go, sheesh, I could do that. Anybody can do that. Let me have that. Sit down there and talk to people on the phone. Listen to their problems. Understand what their needs are. And then route them to the right person to be solved all within 3 seconds. You get three. That's it. 3 seconds, go. It's over. That was it. That was about three, maybe two and a half. It's quick. You got to be witty. You got to be thoughtful. You got to be caring. You got to be considerate. You see, are you prepared mentally to be considerate? You just woke up that morning. Someone in your family's been sick, so you didn't sleep well, real well. Not necessarily a good start. You just woke up that morning. You missed your breakfast. Kind of cranky. No coffee. I was out of coffee. Didn't realize it. Not so happy. Phone's about to ring at the office. You just woke up that morning, drove through, and spilled coffee on you on the way to work. Now you got a blouse that's got something. You got a shirt, guys, that's on you. Doesn't fit. Doesn't work. All of a sudden, your day's not too good, but guess what? At 8:01, the phone's going to ring, and I need somebody answering that phone that sounds bright, brilliant, and has all the answers. And the answers can be, sir, I don't know, but let me have someone get back in touch with you. That's all that it takes. You see, you got a hold button on that phone. If you ever have that hold button on your iPhones, use it. If you don't know the answer, pause. Don't say something stupid. Don't lie. It's going to come back and bite you because you got to back it up, right? So find your inner strength. Understand technology. Understand how to use your technology. And understand how to hold your lips. When you don't have the answer, it's okay. Just say, not sure right now, sir, but I can get right back to you. Works in any field you work in. Engineers, got it. Business, got it. Sales, got it. Anything. Math, got it. Don't know the answer, but let me get back to you. Okay? It's a real easy way for people to pause. But you have to be prepared. And when I say prepared and getting through your day, I always think about it. Part of the preparedness, as I said, was mental. Part of it is physical. And part of it, a big, big part of it, is how do you look? You see, we get 1 second or so to give that first impression. I get a first impression from everybody in here when I look across the room. The great thing about looking at all of you, you look darn smart. You look like you can do anything you want. You look like you're ready to go. I like it. Now, if I'd have walked in here with a pair of flip-flops, some torn-out jeans, and an old t-shirt that went Yay Lamar across the front, and I'm supposed to give you your inner strength, you're going to be looking at me like, who's this guy doing? He looked like he just got back from Crystal Beach. And so the storyline is, I present who I am when I arrive in 1 second by the way I look, by what I do, by the methods I take. Because without that, you have a preconceived notion of failure before we start. And I wouldn't want that for you. And so what I'm telling you is to look at yourself when you're getting prepared for the various things you must tackle. If you're digging ditches, sure. You want to jump in there with all the best gear you got to protect yourself and the best work boots and dig that ditch to the best of your ability. I really don't care what you all become in your lifestyles. I will ask you one thing. Please be the very best of what it is, whatever you become. If you dig ditches, dig them to the best of your ability, the strongest way you know how, straight line, with all the sides straight. And if you are a nurse, nurse with care, compassion, give it everything you have. That's the whole storyline here of finding your strengths. It's giving all that you have to others. It's not always going to be about what they're going to give you. Now, I told you a minute ago, it's all about you. That statement, all about you, is because it's all about you whether you succeed or fail. You see, all of your parents and your relatives and everyone is so far, so behind you. They've helped you financially, in most cases, get to where you are. Someone connected to you probably helped. Maybe not to pay your tuition, but to give you the incentive. Maybe not to give you the incentive, but to help you get transportation. Maybe not to give the transportation, but to help you get lodging. You see, there's all kind of folks connected to one another in this room through our needs and through our actions. And so what we've got is a series of folks who have helped you get to where you are. I have a tremendous amount of folks who've helped me get where I am. They are employees, they are friends, they are mentors. And as I'm working with each one of them, we always have a quiet conversation at one time of the day. And guess what I tell them? Thank you. Thank you for helping me. Thank you for being there. I really appreciate that. You know, that's one of the most shocking moments for employees to hear that from an owner. Thank you. Thank you for being there. Think about what it means when you say it back to your moms, your dads, your aunts, your uncles, your grandparents, the friends in your family who helped you get where you are today. Take a moment. Walk up to those people. Shake their hands firmly. Put your arm around them and say the words they are dying to hear. Thank you. That meant the most to me. I'm enjoying my year at Lamar. It is wonderful. You won't believe what I'm accomplishing. And you can say, and I stumped my toe a few times and didn't do so well. It's okay. Everybody does. Or maybe you've got a continuous line of I've stumped my toe. Hey, some of us have those kind of days. There's some days when I stump my toe and then I get up the next morning and go, that ain't gonna happen. I got it this time. Throw the ball to me, coach. I got it. I dropped the dang ball again. Something else happens. Tripped up second day. But about that third day, you go, oh, man, if this happens one more time, I don't know what I'm going to do. Get ready. You may be in for a week of it. Well, that's when you got to find your strengths. It's not whenever it's easy that you need your strengths. You ever notice that? When everything's going your way, you're like the smartest person. You can walk on water. You got it all. There's nothing in your way when you got it all going your way. When you got it going your way, it's just the greatest feeling. You can throw a piece of paper in a waste paper basket 50 feet away and rope it. You're like, yes, you got that, not a problem. Shoot again. But then on those days that you're tripped up and you're not sure, what in the world did I do? How did that happen? I thought I had that test. Everything was going my way. What in the world? Well, you've got to sit down. And let me ask you this question. Show me hands. How many talk to yourself? How many talk to yourself? Great. Great. How many answer? Great. Okay. That's self-therapy. There's nothing better than self-therapy. You know why? Because when you talk to yourself, guess who gets to listen? Only one person. There's no other interruptions. And you get to listen to yourself say what's going wrong. And then you get to hear yourself say whatever darn excuse you came up with why it didn't work. What's funny? I should have done that. I know. Yeah, but I was busy. Man, I had all that other stuff to do. I know. I should have done it. I know. But I, on the other hand, you know, I needed to be at that movie. I had to be there. It was the newest movie out. I had to go. Yeah, but you should have been there. You should have been at your mom's birthday party. Yeah, I know, but I mean, you know, she understands. It's just mom. She understands. It'll work. And they'll get over it anyway. You talk yourself through a bunch of excuses when your inside is telling you differently. You better listen to your gut. Listen to your gut. Find your strengths. Listen to yourself. Talk to yourself in private areas, driving in the car, while you're jogging, riding a bicycle, going around shopping. There's no way around you to hear because otherwise they're going to start looking over their shoulder. Wherever you find it comfortable, talk to yourself. Figure out your inner strengths by listening to you. You know what the answers are. Sometimes we cloud them. There's an image going on. I've got to look this way. Therefore, I make no mistakes. I am who I am. Talk to the hand. Right. No, it's not like that. It doesn't work like that. It's not reality when you do that. You have to understand that when you talk to yourself, you'll be able to hear the answers you need to hear. Your internal voice will talk to you. It'll help you understand that you have to dig deeper. You have to do some things in this life you're not going to like doing some days. We all know it. We all do it. And so when you find those moments, you have to dig down and figure out what it is. And then you step into that area of correction. If you can't make yourself get up early enough, you've got to start tricking yourself. Remember we talked about that a minute ago. You've got to start tricking yourself to get up earlier. If you can't figure out how to study that topic that you're involved in here at class at Lamar, you either, one, find a group that you can study with. Two, dig into it deeper all on your own. Three, research like crazy with some other individual that's doing well in that class. Four, obviously go see the professor. Their aides, their assistants, all the others. You know what you got to do. You know how to break the logjam. But how do you do it whenever the test is you? You are the test and you are the answer. Think about that one. You are the test and you are the answer. Learn how to become that person that can look at your own faults and then say, I can do better than that. I'm smart. I'm bright. I'm kind. I'm a good person. And I'm going to do better. It's okay to talk to yourself like that. And when it happens, you want to be able to say, that's not like me. That is not like me. Whew. I got to get help with myself. Come on. So you'll see me walking around out in those beautiful oak trees down that sidewalk going, okay, buddy, Gerald, you better get a handle on this. You better get a handle on this quick. This isn't the way it's supposed to be. Let's get it together. Get your act together. Let's go. And you start running down it. Are you awake? Are you ready? Right on down the list. What have I got to do? Who's next? What's going on? And pretty soon, you'll see all of a sudden your aura will change. You'll go from a dark cloud that Snoopy and Charlie Brown used to have running around on them, and it'll flip. And all of a sudden, sunshine will show up. And sunshine shows up because you intended it to. Because you intended to do better. You're all of a sudden, you ever heard that old story? The harder I work, the luckier I get. Every time I work real, real hard, boop, something pops up. I go, dang it, that was sweet. I'll take it. And so the harder you work, the luckier you get. So change in that mindset of what you need to do to be the successful one you intend to be, and you will find it. Again, all of you are going to be successful. Some of you are going to run a longer trail. You know, we don't have GPS to success. I can't plug in address, success, enter, and it's going to come on. Be careful, there's police around and marker. There's a turn, traffic's deep. You know, I mean, you just don't get that. What you get is what you have. You have the ability to look at yourself in the mirror each day, get prepared, talk to yourself, work yourself out of a problem. I want you to really think about that. It's really not as difficult as it seems, although there are handicaps along the way. Now let's go into another area. Let's go into, are you thankful? You know, we spoke about that a minute ago. Are you thankful? You know, in being successful and being able to recruit others to help you be successful, you have to have one common denominator, and that is you can't do it all by yourself in this world. Somewhere, someplace, at some given time, you're going to need others to help you. Okay? So when you are having other folks help you in your chores of what you are personally trying to accomplish, the best thing for you is to be able to recognize it and say thank you. It's the most helpful thing at the checkout counter people can say. I was in a store just a few days ago, and I walked in, and I must have been told, welcome, thank you, how are you, good to see you, finding everything you need, maybe six times, and I hadn't gotten any further than the width of this room. There were so many people hitting me, one after the other. It was a little intimidating at first, and then I thought, oh, wow. These people really do want my business. These people really do care. And so then as we get through the end and I'm checking out after I've gotten what I want, I go, well, thank you. And they go, well, thank you. No, we really appreciate you. Then as I walk by the next guy, and he says, thank you again. Well, thank you. And I feel like one of the comedy acts where you see somebody saying thank you about six times. And I'm just trying to get out the door. But the experience left me with, I'm very touched by that they want my business and they admire me for being their customer. Because look, you can all spend your money anywhere you want to spend it. But be sure, and you'll make note of this, you'll probably find that you're spending your money where you enjoy it. If you enjoy the service, if you enjoy the people waiting on you, if you enjoy the product, you're going to go back. Now, sometimes there's a line, and you go, gee, I just wanted a pizza, but But I got to stand in this line. But it's the place I need to be, and it's the location that's got the best pizza that I like and everything else associated. And so all of a sudden, you go, you know what, standing in this line is not such a bad deal. I'll just be right there. But you will be thankful whenever you receive it. And so I want you to remember that being thankful to those who helped you along the way, again, is so important that you're able to use that to your benefit. I find a lot of times that I make sales calls to a variety of different companies, and people come to see me as well, as I said. And so the greeting is, hello, how are you? And then at the end is always thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being there. Thank you for allowing me to spend time with you. Any numbers of things, but certainly you want to be able to have the ability to say thank you in your repertoire of what you need and what you have to find your strength. I want to also bring up one of the other points, and I want to open this up to questions, because I get a lot of times that we can all solve problems internally by discussing your problems, not maybe my perspective. So we're about to go to questions in just a minute. But the storyline that I want you to consider, is in finding your strengths, are you determined? Are you determined to find your strengths? So, in that, I mean, do you give up easy? Do you scoff at the idea of success? Do you tell yourself, I'm really not going to be successful? I'm really not going to be that successful? I don't intend to do this later, any number of reasons that you've now kind of written yourself off on that success plateau? Or are you one of the ones that have said, I'm going to be successful. I don't care what it takes. I'm going to be determined. I intend to follow through. I'm going to give it my all. I'm going to stand tall. I may get knocked down, but I'm getting back up. And I'm going to go forward until I finish what my goals are. You see, that's true determination. There's a lot of times you're going to find that you did everything right. Everything. Everything. And you didn't make it for whatever the scenario was. You see, I have business deals that go that way. I put proposals together all the time for people to look at. And our proposals are exactly right. Exactly what they needed. All the answers are there. All the numbers are correct. All the due diligence of research and preparedness and arrangements and photographs and PowerPoints and all the geographic information necessary, it's all there. It's 100% right. There's no way this is going to fail. But it fails because of human contact with others. You know, some may say, well, it's political. Sometimes it is. Now, I don't mean politics on a national basis. I mean politics in a business basis. Like when you're submitting something to a business, just as you would think of turning in a proposal, and you've got all your numbers perfect, but they take the other guy, they take the other company, because that company had an internal friend to somebody else. And so all your hard work and all your good things that you did failed. And so you have to ask yourself, well, that's it. You just throw the papers in the air and say, that's it, I'm through. I'm not doing that again. That's ridiculous. Or do you say, you know what, I didn't get it this time. I know my numbers are right. I know my product was good. I know everything about it was on target. But I didn't get selected. Are you determined enough to go in? Can you stay in the race? You know, there's a saying of, if it's too hot in the kitchen, you know, you want to get out. It's just too hot. A lot of you are going to apply for loans in the near future and long term. You're going to apply for loans. You're going to need a car loan. You're going to need a business loan. You need a house loan. You're going to need any type of financial methods to help you get to your goal. Maybe you want to buy a car for the first time. Maybe you want to pay off something that you bought. Maybe you want to turn around and buy your first house in years to come. Don't be surprised if you get turned down. I get turned down all the time in business deals. For years, our business is now 30 years old. And so for the early years, I couldn't borrow money to buy coffee. It didn't matter. I kept working, kept trying, kept gaining strength, kept getting it back up. You're going to get knocked down in this world. And finding your strength is the guy and the gal who can put it together when you've got a low punch, when you didn't expect it, when it's one of those times that you are now defeated. And you go, now what? I needed that. You dust yourself off, you look yourself in the mirror, and you go, that's okay. We're going to make this. It's going to go just fine. Don't you dare worry about it. I'm marching through this. It's not the end of the world. I got something else ahead. Don't worry about what you didn't achieve at that moment if you get an internal setback in a business or an offer or an application for a job or the ability for you to perform. Don't you worry about it. Gather your internal strength. Figure out from inside the dynamics of what happened. Was it my product that was wrong? Or did I just get overlooked? Or did it just not get recognized? Or was it some political sabotage? You see, deals are made all the time. And banks make loans all the time. And I have great friends that are bank officers. Look, I'm not beating up on loan officers or banks. I love them. We have relationships with four different banks in this area. And we like all of them. But they all have their limits. Have you ever thought about this as a bank? Did you know banks sell a product just like they sell gasoline and milk at the stores? They have a product. It's called money. If you're a good risk, they'll loan it to you. If you're not a good risk at that time, they're not going to loan it to you. If you're a risk that is at this time in their portfolio of loans that they have, that you just don't quite fit what they're looking for, and they tell you no, okay, let's make up a scenario. I want to start a pecan tree farm, and I'm going to gather pecans. And you go, really? You go, yeah, you know how many pecans there are? Pecans sell like so crazy. I mean, they're used in recipes, and they're used in bakeries, and it's just worldwide. Man, this is the region. You can grow pecans easily here. You can harvest them real easy. Oh, great. That's wonderful. Well, come see our agricultural department, and they'll talk to you about the loan. You go, great, great. I need a truck. I need some tractors. We're going to have the watering system. We've got all the trees. We're already going to be planting and mowing on. And then we got a distribution. Great. How much do you think you're going to need? You tell them the number, and they go, okay. What have you got to repay it? Well, it's 10 years before we really get pecans off of these trees. They may not want to make a loan. And you had all your numbers right. It's just not the right place where you went to go get your money. But don't get discouraged. Guess what? The government has loans for that. Agricultural loans, where you can apply through different agencies to get the benefit of getting started. And so all of a sudden, it's not that you didn't do a good job. You just got to go to another source. You've got to find your inner strength to keep yourself up and to drive yourself through the low spots. That's the whole point of this message at this time. Driving yourself through the low spot. Because if you stay where it drops you off at, you'll never think you're going to be successful the next day. And you are. You're going to be successful. But you're going to have to climb over a lot of rocks some days to get to the high points. You know, mountains are really tall. The sand is really low. Everybody can negotiate sand. It's the mountains that are tough. And so you're going to have to climb up there to be successful, and you're going to scrape and drop and fall, and all kinds of things are going to happen to you. But I want you to be successful in your mind. Keep yourself positive. Don't let someone tell you, I'm sorry, I can't help you. And it deflates you to a point you can't move on. You say, no problem. I understood. I thought I'd just at least contact you, and I'll be with some others. You're great. Nice seeing you. Good knowing you. Thank you for your time. You walk away quietly, and you're fine and reserved. Now, you can go get in your car and beat that steering wheel to death. You can do anything you want with that steering wheel just before you start the car. Don't do it while you're driving. And so, as you keep going along, understand that you're going to have those setbacks from different things But I want you to find the method, the way that helps you find your strength. Okay? So here's what we've talked about so far. We've talked about, are you awake and are you ready? We've talked about, are you prepared? How do you get yourself prepared for the day? We've talked about, are you thankful? Are you thankful what you have and what you've done, and as you accomplish things, thanking those that helped you along the way? And finally, are you determined? Are you determined? You know what I tell some of my family members? They want to do something. We always have these grandiose ideas at our dinner table. Hey, Dad, you know what? Why don't we do this? And it's probably more than I had ever dreamed to do in a moment, and much less like in the next month. And so I go, well, not now, but not never. Think about that. Not now, but not never. Because there's always the possibility. No, you may not do something right now that you're wanting to do, but don't let that deflate you. Not now does not mean not never. It just means, hold it a minute. You may not quite be ready for what you're asking for. You may end up having to figure out that there's a few more growing steps to go before you get what you get. Okay? And some of my best deals ever in life are the deals I missed. Think about that. All right, here's one for you. Let's put it this way. How many of you haven't gone out with a date with somebody you thought you were going to go out on a date with, that you wished you'd gone out on a date with, that you didn't get it, and then found out later on, boy, I'm sure glad I didn't go out with them. It's the same thing. Some of the best deals I've ever had are the deals I never got. Thank goodness I didn't get them. And the same could be held true for personal relationships. Man, you're thinking, this guy is the one. This girl is the one. Then later on, you around it a little bit more, and you go, and you start walking way over here going, I don't want any part of that. That's way too much drama. Okay, so that happens. So finding your strength, and again, you're kind of talking to yourself, you're getting yourself through it, but this is all about figuring out what's good for you. And this whole subject of being here today is all about what's good for you. And it's all individualized. Okay? It's all individualized. But the reality is there's so many parallels. There's not that much differences in all of us looking for success. There is a lot of difference in who applies it. I have some very, very successful people, and they start out like a rocket ship every morning. I mean, like the bell is on. They look like a thoroughbred that ran out of the track. Just shoot. And I have others that beep and bop alone, and they got their coffee, and they're getting going, and it takes them just a little bit, and then when they strike gold, they're off. Everybody's got their own flight pattern. Everybody's got their own approach. But the end result is, get it done. Do what you got to do. End it. So now let's talk about you. Let's open this whole floor up to questions. Fire at me with questions that bother you in finding your strengths, or examples of something going on with you that you have. Any questions? Fire up. Oh, come on now. I ain't been here this long and nobody's got any questions. There's a lot of gray hair here. There's a lot of answers underneath it. Trust me. Let me give you background. I got two girls. One's older, one's younger. Beautiful wife, a girl dog. The only testosterone in the house is me. I lose every battle. It doesn't matter where we're going to go to eat. I don't care. It's okay. What do y'all want to go see in the movie? Whatever they want. It's okay. If I got to get out of the house, I'll go down the street and see one of my buddies. It's no big deal. It's my life, and I've become to love it. But what about you? What questions do you have? What challenges? What do you see? Okay.
I'm going to try to word this the best I can. What advice would you give to, like, recent college graduates who are applying for the workforce? And, you know, a lot of people want experience. We want experience. We want this. We want that. But you just graduated, you know, and then when you're trying to get experience, they want experience,
Right. No, it's an age-old.
Between a rock
It's an age-old problem. You're exactly right. What you just outlined is the employer's best dream. They want somebody they can hire at a beginner's level that has the experience of a 20-year veteran. There's no such thing. It's an employer's dream. However, how do you combat that with your question? You go to every one of your interviews that you can in person. Listen, emails are great. Okay? Text messages are great. Phone calls are even better because you get to hear voice inflection. You understand emotion. But nothing beats a strong handshake. How are you? Great to see you. I applied. And I'd certainly like to apply and work with you. And so when they say, listen, we're looking for somebody with more experience, you go, I'm a fast learner. I understand your circumstance. I've studied a little bit about your company. And it's always great if you go to an interview, if you're going to go see somebody, by golly, at least Google them. At least. Know what they sell. Know how much they sell. Know where they're at, their regional market, what they offer, what they're doing, what their goals are. Know something about them. And then hit them with their own words and watch their eyes go, whoop. Because they're going to go, ooh, she does know. And you've got to make yourself stand out from the rest of the applicants, right? And you don't have any experience. They know that because you have graduated from Lamar University. But you say, I'm really willing to work hard. I'm really willing to stay after hours. I can come in earlier. We can make this go. I'm a great runner. I'm a good listener. And then start just blowing out all of your plus signs. I type 100 miles an hour. I do this. I'm the best scanner in the world. I've got the ability to use a highlighter like nobody's ever seen. You just lay it all out there, and you just jam them with all the greatness you are. And at that point, they start going, wow, this person really wants this job. I like that. I think we could use you. And that's how it starts. But if you walk in and they go, hey, we're looking for more experience, you go, that's okay. And that's what you get. You get the door. You don't get it. Look, you may go down. You ever have those old things about people fighting and they'll just, hey, you may go down, but you're going to go down swinging. Well, go down swinging. Let them have it. Let them have all you got. Big smiles. Great handshakes. I look so good. And please dress the part for whatever the job is, okay? If you go for an interview, my gosh, please dress the part. If it's a clothier store, look like you own the store. If it's for a cement company, come in hard-toe boots. You know, get with the hard hat. Look like you meant to go to work there. If you look like you're going to Starbucks to get coffee, they're probably not going to have a position for you. You got to act the part, look the part. You know, what's the old story? Walks like a duck, quacks like a duck? Probably a duck. That's how you get involved. That's how you get included. We all want to be inclusive. All want to be inclusive. Everybody wants to be a part of it. Of this whole world, we all want to be inclusive. The best way to be inclusive is how? Get involved. Be a part of what's going on around you. That's why campus life is so neat. You guys can all get involved in campus life and be a part of what Lamar offers. If you just study, go home, study, go home, study, go home. Okay, first of all, you'll have a GPA of 4.0. But the second thing is, you're going to miss a little bit of the atmosphere. Okay? So now what you got to do is a balance in that. I need the 4.0, and I want to enjoy a little activity at Lamar. Because balance in life is what gets you there. Okay? Any of you waiters or waitresses? Some of you done that? Okay. All right. How hard is it to carry a tray of water and iced tea in one hand and it's 3 feet in diameter? And you're like this, trying to get through the chairs, and you're doing it. I'm always amazed. It is the greatest feat to see a 120-pound girl carry 55 pounds over her head. Nearly half her weight is over her head, and she's going through it and moving chairs and grinning and smiling, and she's going to be right there. And then watch this. She comes around and then starts handing it out. Wow. And the guys do it. The girls do it. Everybody's in it. They never drop anything. Occasionally they do, but you know, by and large, the percents are low. And so the reality is they were there involved in it. They got involved in what's going on. I want you to get involved. Next question. crickets are no fun. Give me something. Ask something. Yeah.
How do you work with sleep deprivation or tight schedule when you just can't have the time for rest?
It's a tough one. It's a tough one whenever you're really watching your you know, it's all about hours and allocation, okay? And you're going to be the best judge of it. You're trying to pound out some tremendous homework and great research and all the other things. You may be involved in a job. You may have other reasons that you're up and about. You're going to really have to find that you're going to, you know, if you continue to do sleep deprivation, starts off as a minor little thing. I missed a few hours of sleep, and then the next day it grows, and then it grows, and it's like the proverbial grains of sand. Pretty soon it's going to flip everything over. And so it affects you in a million ways. First thing it affects, attitude. First thing to go, boom. You ever get real sleepy? First thing happens, get real cranky. Second thing happens, memory. Can't retain things. Distracted easy. Can't seem to be on the ball. Then that's when you start having auto accidents, on the job accidents, your work becomes sloppy. The answer to that is, that's something that you literally got to try to take minutes of the day and put some power naps in there. And that means you just nod off underneath one of those beautiful oak trees for a few minutes. And I found that a 15 minute nap is better than zip. Now you would think, oh no, that's going to make it worse. I'm not going to be able to get going again. Yeah, I know, you may need one more cup of coffee to get going again, but your body will thank you for that little power surge. Look, when your batteries on your phone start to go low, and you give it just a little bit more charge, it takes it, right? And then you can keep going. Your body's the same way as your phone. Plug it in, give it a rest, get everything quiet, get everything turned off, dim out lights, take the nap. Figure out what you got to do. And at home, go to sleep in a time fashion that puts you where you start turning out lights and lowering your activity before you climb in bed. If you run into your room and jump into the bed and decide you're not going to go to sleep, it's going to be probably not so successful. So, much like anything else, dim the lights, dim the noise, dim the activities. Get yourself prepared, whatever your normal ritual for bed is at that point, and get in there. No other TVs, no other activities, all the other stuff, just silence, and that'll help you. Another question? Yes, ma'am.
When you're interviewing people to work in your company, what are questions or answers that tell you that they are good?
That they're going to be a good candidate?
That they're going to be a good.
Well, the first thing I want to see is I want to see the brightness in their eyes. See, you read a whole bunch of things through people in their eyes. Unless you're looking away from me, and if there's a reason, I want to know why you're not looking at me whenever I'm interviewing you. But your eyes tell the story of who you are. Your eyes. And that's why everybody has these new security readers where they do your eye and your retina scanning. Okay? Because your eyes tell who you are. And what you are now. In a personal relationship where you're trying to get involved in a company and you're trying to be hired, you want to see the smile and you want to see the eyes. You want to see the conversations one-on-one. I find so many people, watch this, who shake hands like this. And I see. I mean, I'm like I'm talking to this carpet. No, when you come in to shake hands, you want a strong handshake, man or woman, doesn't matter, strong. If you find them light, don't grip them to death, okay? Back off. But you want a strong handshake. It shows positive. It shows consciousness. It shows self-confidence, okay? And you want to be a direct eyeball to eyeball, man to man, woman to woman, doesn't matter. Gotta be direct. Direct. Now, if you're a little nervous about that, I want you to practice on your friends. Make it where it's somebody you do know. Mom, dad, grandmother, whatever. It's got to be strong. Okay? And I showed that to my youngest. And now she goes, did you see that handshake I gave that guy? I go, yeah! Real good. Way to go. She goes, I looked him in the eye too. I go, great! That's what it's all about. Look him in the eye. They're all there to help you and figure out what's going on and do you fit in. And if you fit in, they want you. Back to that, we want you to fit in. But if you don't fit in, it's probably not going to go real well. So the questions are normally, how many hours am I going to be working? What's the normal hours? What do you expect of me to do? What all is going to be going on? And we go over a variety of those things. But I'm always trying to figure out what's their angle. Because remember, you're trying to figure out what's my angle. What's he want? What's he want? Can I do it? I don't know. Not sure about this place. Not sure if I want to do this or that. And so all of a sudden, we're saying, what part of what you're telling me is real? And what part of what you're telling me is exaggerated? Now, that's a big thing. You go, well, you exaggerated. I just graduated. I haven't done anything yet. No, I understand. I understand that. But what I'm trying to tell you is I'm looking for the person who is the self-starter, who is able to accomplish with little direction, but follows directions well. Okay? If you're one of those people in the world that says, that doesn't apply to me, they didn't mean that to me. They meant that to everybody else. But not me. My wife is one of those people. Whenever there's something going on, she wants to go around the group. Whenever there's something going on, you're waiting here, doing this, doing that. I go, oh, they just must not know you're Mrs. Condon, huh? I guess that's why you're going around everything. I said, no, you have to be involved with everybody else and be a part of it, just like everybody else. But you have to be involved in the numbers of looking at people, listening to people, understanding what they want, and then reaching out, shaking hands, and being a part of it. Because I want you in my company if you want to be in my company. I don't want a hostage situation. I don't want to hold you hostage, and I don't want you to hold me hostage. We all want to work together. And the last thing I want to think about is whether or not you're fitting in. Because at that point, you're already in. And now, as you've heard the old saying, one bad apple spoils the bunch. That's why we want to research who you are, what you are, how you act, how you interact. Are you a morning person? Are you an afternoon person? What's your preference? Can you laugh with the group? Do you enjoy laughter? Do you only think of sad things? I mean, where are you? And that's what we have to all figure out during these interviews. And sometimes it takes a couple of interviews. But it's truthful, straightforward, looking at them, getting involved, all of that is the right answer for trying to get you hired. And don't be afraid to ask questions. Okay? Don't be afraid. I was just wondering, sir. I have a little short question here. I have a couple of questions, as a matter of fact. I have about 20 questions. Well, you may not want to bring 20, but if you've got about the first four, five, because remember, you're going to research who they are. So you're going to know as much about them as you can find, about where you're working, about what's intended for you to do, and then you're going to get me in there ready to go. And you're going to look the part, you're going to be fresh, you're going to be alert, you're going to be sharp, and then you're going to be able to go back in there and really tackle it. Now, you know what? There's times, folks, because I have had businesses and worked with people, I have always wondered, I wonder what it would be like if you gave me only a piece of cardboard and a Sharpie, and I wrote on the Sharpie that I needed help, and I stood on the corner, could I get help to eventually get a job? I think that's a real social puzzle. In other words, are you good enough? Do you think yourself right now, or you've never been hired, but do you think you could hold a cardboard out there on the street corner and end up getting a job? I bet you can. I bet you can. Because look, you got your cardboard. You're wanting to do something. I'll go to work. I bet you're going to get several different groups to offer you jobs by walking up to that car, shaking hands, saying, how are you? What can you do? What's your skills? Boom, boom, boom. I mean, it's not that hard to get hired. On the other hand, there has to be a need. If there isn't a need, they need experience, it's going to be a little tougher. But getting hired is not that hard when you present yourself in a truthful, proper manner. Truthful, proper manner. Another question. This one.
I want to own my own business one day, and I pitched it just last week, and it was turned down. So I tweaked it a little, thought about it a lot, you know, pitched it again, and it was accepted. So as a small business startup, what's your advice?
Well,
do you have any
No, there's not a literature that I have that I could hand you. I can tell you volumes about it. What you did was the right method. You measure twice, cut once. And so you measured it, and it didn't quite fit for what they wanted or what they were suggesting. You went back and trimmed it a little bit, remeasured it, cut again, fit. And so the storyline to that is you being able to self-adapt to meet the circumstances and then be accepted was the goal of the day. You did great. Now, the rest of this time for you owning your own business is about diligence. The due diligence of studying everything you can get in your field and then the ability to perform. I didn't speak of one word that's so important that you have, and that's execution. Execute, execute, execute. In the Nike world, it was just do it. The storyline is all of us have a million ideas. If I'd have taken the time here today to say, spread your ideas out, we're going to write them on the board, we could have written a million ideas of what would possibly you'd like to do, what might be a plan of yours, and then we'd have all walked out of here and possibly none of them would have gotten performed. When you start thinking about what you want to do and how you want to do something, particularly if you want to be in business for yourself, is your day is all about knowledge and research. Knowledge, research, diligence, good contract, bad product, good employee, not so good for our group, owning, owning, good location, not a good location, make a lease, don't do this now, buy a company car, no hold off, employee programs, health benefits, I don't know. And you're going to go through all these little scenarios that I keep bouncing around on. But the real reality comes down to when you finally make decisions, execute. Right then. I went dove hunting once before in Argentina, and the doves are everywhere in Argentina. It's a gorgeous land. The landscape is beautiful. The food was fantastic. The doves were a dove hunter's dream. We've got these dove boys that are working with us in this tour guide to make sure we're comfortable and we're safe. And the doves are flying over, and I'm bang, I miss that one. Bang, I miss that one. The little dove boy came up to me. He says, "Senor," he says, "study long, study wrong, pull and shoot." How simple was that? Pull and shoot. Next thing you know, I put that gun to my shoulder, fall over, bang, dropped. Okay, that's what I'm saying. Study long, study wrong. This is from a guy who's 15 years old. Study long, study wrong, pull and shoot. When you're in a situation you need to make a decision, do it. Do it. As my old dad, who's passed away, used to tell me, do something, Gerald, even if it's wrong, do something. Because standing there ain't going to get it. So if you're in your own business, if you're working for Starbucks, and you've got nothing to do, and you just stand here like this, they're probably going to go, come here, come here. And eventually they're going to say, you got to start doing something. We're going to have to let you go. I mean, come on. Let's get with the program. Get your head in the game. Back where we started. Are you ready? Get your head in the game. Are you either going to do something here, young man, or we got to just let you go. I'm sorry. So, if you don't know what to do, if you're not sure, start cleaning up, start working up, start saying, who can I help, what can I do, what's going on? In your world, it's what I need to be on top, what I need to do to be on top of my game, who's my competitor, what's the best deal for me, how am I going to execute it? 100 reasons you'll have questions, and they'll be waking you up in the middle of the night. You'll be the sleep-deprived one in the room real soon, but I'm proud of you. Way to go. Next question? Yes, sir.
With the large companies having their application process just online now, do you have any suggestions to get to the top of the list and get an interview?
Yeah, I would say you gotta try to start making inside connections somehow, some way. You gotta start finding out where they all hang out. I mean, if it's an out-of-town company, yeah, it's tough. But if you're gonna go and work for some big engineering firm, if you can figure out where the engineers hang out and go hang out with them, look like you're already employed and get in there with them and mingle. Because if you can drink coffee or you can drink something stronger than coffee if that's what they're drinking, and you're eligible to do that. That you get in there and you start, hey, good seeing you, how are you? And if you're not known, make yourself a business card on the computer. A business card. Don't go to an interview without your personal business card. Okay? Take your business card with you. You got to have something to hand out, right? A handshake's great, an eyeball's great, but all of a sudden, I don't know who you are. I don't know what to do. So you got to leave something. And then now here we've got technology. You've got a number, I'll share my contact with you. Please. Okay? And somewhere you can put in the remarks column, applicant for new job, or whatever else you want to be, studying in engineering, studying in business, I'm great at math, forte is this way, I cook great sushi. Whatever you want to do, put it in there in your remark column, and you share that contact, all of a sudden you go, oh, yeah, here we go. This is the guy I was talking about. This is it. So business card, handshake, share a contact. You get in there with it. Got to be seen, got to be heard. Now, I don't know when this class is over. So I think it's when the bell rings. But if you got to leave early, then hurt my feelings. I got a lot of people who walk out on me all the time. So unless you got other questions, I'm here to answer questions. Good. Well, thank you. Thank you.